Welcome back, everyone. This is Chris from the KUKA Simulations team, and today I'm going to show you part two of the safe operation configuration in KUKA Sim. Again, the disclaimer, make sure to test your configuration on WorkVisual and the real robot before doing the safety acceptance test following the product documentation. Today on the agenda, we have the monitoring spaces as well as the reference position and the axis and velocity monitoring. Let's get right back into KUKA Sim, where we're going to add a new Cartesian workspace with the right click here. And then we can select the space here and configure it. So we're going to have a protected space over the pen magazine. It's going to be always active, and we're going to stop at the boundaries. And now we can use our cool feature that we just drag and drop our box wherever we need. And now I can change the size and turn it as I need it. And for example, I'm going to make it only 300 in X and 580 in Y and 1.50 in Z. And now I have all the pen magazine nicely wrapped. Going to add another workspace, Cartesian one, for example, the workspace going to over the table. It's going to be active by input because I want to go out. I want to stop at the boundaries. Yes. And now I can also just snap it with the snap function on the corner of my table and then turn it. So it's nicely parallel now, and then also reduce the size to here 500 in depth, so it's just over my table right now. If I add a new axis specific workspace, I can change all, I can select the axis that I want to activate and change the values right here. So maybe from -70 to 100 degrees. This is all values that I can check on the real robot afterwards if they are, or on here. This is actually nice and easy. And exactly, that's how you do the monitoring spaces. You can also activate and deactivate them by signal, whatever you want here, depending on your application, of course. Now, let's continue with the reference position. I already did a little program here where I go to my reference point on the lower side there. So when you're in the safe operation, you selected the point that you have, you can directly go and touch up over here, and it takes all the values that you have. So we're green because we're not too close to the initiation point. Looks good, perfect. Let's continue with the axis monitoring. This is, as in WorkVisual, you can select the axis that you want to monitor and select also the groups and the axis that for an operational stop. This is, as you know it from the KUKA College, kind of easygoing. And you can do the same with the velocity monitoring, where you can reduce the speed, I don't know, to 2 meters per second, and the T1, you can reduce it to 150. As you need it for your application, and the same as you can minimize or maximize, to put in the maximum axis velocity here, like, I don't know, 500. And this is all for now. I'm going to show you how to export it in the next video. I hope you enjoy it. Leave a comment below or a like, and I hope you also can have these features on your KUKA Sim, and hope to see you for the part three, the next video, where we're going to export it to WorkVisual and show the stop service. Until then, cheers, everyone.
Industrial intelligence.